So those who heard it second time, you know how boring the teacher's life is, because they say the same story over and over again.
Okay.
So, who wants to be a teacher? Now, so let's continue. So now I have a boat. So this boat here left Changi Jetty to Pulau Ubin. So Jetty is here, I'm going to Ubin. Then after that, he continued his journey to Pulau Seru. Don't know where is it. Then another jetty left here again, but go straight to Seru. So now there are two boats, right? They said, did they arrive in the same destination?
Yeah.
Yes. Right? So it's a simple question. So we just reply yes. Now, this is the concept of additional vectors. Because to go to the same place, there are two or more different routes. Can you understand this part?
Yeah.
So I can either walk straight, or I can go here, then go all the way there. For example, I want to go from Sengkang to another MRT station. No, Wangkok is city. Wangkok is only one way. Let's say I want to go from Sengkang to Paya Lebar. So what must I do? I must first Sengkang go to Serangoon, change the train to Paya Lebar, right? I can also take a bus to somewhere and go to Paya Lebar. So this is the idea of additional vectors. I add vectors, but after that, the destination is still the same. Am I talking sense? Now let's try here. If the boats go from P to Q and then Q to R, there's a combined translation from what to what? So let me try. If my boat move from P to Q, if I move from P to Q, Q to R, is the same as moving from P to where?
R.
So this answer is P and R. Can follow?
Yeah.
Make sense? Okay. So then I say, therefore, PQ plus QR will be equals to PR. Alright? This is known as addition of vectors. I'm tempted to write resultant factor. Okay, resultant vector, also addition of vector. The word resultant comes from the physics concept. So, yeah, but never mind. I will just keep it like that. So I say if PQ is A, QR is B, then PR will be equals to PQ plus QR, which is equals to A plus B. Just like that. So far can follow? Still okay, huh? Some of you are not writing this onto your paper, which I don't know why. So if I were you, I will write now so that I don't have to write later. Because my screen will move up, and once you missed it, you have to watch the video. However, if I say A plus B over here, if I say A vector plus B vector, the length is not the same as if I take the length of A plus the length of B. Two vector, Answer is not correct. But why not? Why not we explore this idea first, then later you tell me what is this word. Now, what does this mean? Let me give you an example. So, can you help me draw a triangle? Okay, I zoom in so that you can focus. I zoom in so you can focus. Okay, can you help me draw a right angle triangle?
Where
do you draw? You draw somewhere on your paper.
Okay, I have a triangle like this.
Alright, so if I say I move from,
okay, I label the triangle. Let's say I label X to Y to Z. Based on the
additional vector just now that we learned, if I move from X to Y to Z, it's the same as moving from X to Z. So which means this vector is called what? Vector A plus B. Vector B. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
So you can write here, this is A.
Not exactly. Later I'll show you other triangle which is not triangle. Okay, let me copy this down on the paper. Well done. Now, of course, all this alphabet doesn't make sense unless I give some number. So let's try.
Can you also help me write magnitude of A is equals to 3? Magnitude of B underscore is equals to 4. Can you make a guess what is magnitude of A plus B?
Is it 7?
So is this very clear on this point? Is it very clear on this point?
Because if this is 3, this is 4, doesn't mean I add together it must be the length of this. Right? Because over here this is still just 5. Does it make sense? Okay. I challenge you. Can I make them equal? Can I make them equal?
Meaning this. Okay, I try. I got a lot of space here, you also have, right? So we try. Can I make this equal to this? Is it possible?
I give you another condition. Assuming the A and B, that's why A and B was forming what? The right angle, right? Now I say I can take A and B, I fix and turn, I can replace them anywhere, like two high angle, Now A and B is like that. If A and B is like that, right angle, this one must be shorter than the two add together, right? How can I move these two so that they are equal to the combined? Make them into 180, does that make sense? So, if I have a line 3, I have a line 4. Together, is it 7?
Yeah.
Does it make sense?
Yeah. So, this is correct only if A is a horizontal line. This is my A. And B is another horizontal line. And these two are what? Parallel.
So, if they are parallel, and I say this is 3 units.
If this is 3 unit, this is 4 unit, isn't it 7 unit here?
Yeah, so like 3 plus 4 gives you 7, right? You understand the two different scenarios?
What about vertical line?
Am I confusing you?
Vertical.
What question? The vertical line is okay as long as 2 are vertical, 3 plus 4 gives you 7.
Sense.
So how do you
view
the two
blanks? I go back. So I zoom in. So just now we discussed, we say that A plus B vector magnitude is not equal to the sum of the individual vector.
Unless they are parallel, then if they are equal. Does it make sense? This is not equal for what? Is it parallel or non-parallel?
Non-parallel.
Is it not given
cost? I'm recording.
Is that a third question?
Yes.
Be quiet.
Hey, Yan Ting, that's rude.
Yeah,
highlighted a bit. Now, this is 3, this is 4, add up together is 7. If this is 3, this is 4. Will it be 7?
No.
That's your turn.
So, what do you know? So non-parallel, okay, I just need a pause already. What is good?
Non-zero.
Non-zero, huh? Okay, good.
You
got last year, what?
Hey, wait, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with that?
Non-zero. But I think we got it for the 10-2, right? But the idea is this. Now, if let's say two vectors are overlapping, definitely it will be shorter, right? So it will not be equal. Non-zero. Can the vector be zero? Okay. Example. I travel from Sengkang to Buangkok, back to Sengkang again. What is the vector?
Zero.
Because why? I walk from my place to Putin and then walk back again. What's my resultant vector?
Zero.
So if the vector is zero, example, if B is zero, then B is zero, will A equals to A?
Yeah.
Good idea.
Okay, good. Continue.
Now, the next part is important. So far we are dealing with the why. Now I teach you the how. Okay? Now, listen, important. Not this one, you get wrong, then you take a long time to catch up. So how? How do we add vectors? How do we add vectors?
How? To add. Now, the key point here is I must have a interchange. Of course, this is an inverted comma because there's no such thing as interchange. But what I mean is, if I want to add two vectors together, I must make sure in between the two of them, it must be the same. It's just like if I want to go from here to Paya Lebar, I must make sure Serangoon is an interchange. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
I cannot alight at Serangoon, then board at Buona Vista, then come back again. Doesn't make sense. So it must be alight at Serangoon, board at Serangoon again, then to travel. So the interchange must be the same.
So this interchange must be the same. So these two
must be the same. Now, only when these two is the same, then the resultant vector will be
No. This is called the start. This is like the end. So the answer will be AC.
Can follow? So today you learn the why, you learn the how. How to add, very simple. If I have AE plus EC, I check. Interchange same, good. Then the resultant will be A and C. Now, what if I change the position?
So now I try. What if I say I want EC, can you write down? Plus AE.
No.
Can add or not?
No.
The C
and, A.
And the A is different.
Yes.
But can I change position?
Yes.
Yes. So I can change.
So I can change. So I'm telling you this and this is same or not the same?
Yeah.
Same.
So I'm telling you the vector can change position. Okay? So you just need to rearrange until you see some common interchange and then you try and see what is the resultant. Now let's try the first one.
Let's try A. Where's my diagram? Oh, here.
Oh.
By the way, for A, right? This is the answer. This is the answer. Hashtag correct already.
Can you now try B?
Okay, I try B with you. I try B with you. Everyone look up.
B, yeah? B. DC plus AC. No, I change the position.
So I change the position. So this one will become BD plus DC, and what's the answer?
BC.
Very good. Anyone close? No. Huh? Oh, good. I like. Again. Huh? Look. Nabil. Say, I write. CD plus DB. Okay, good. I like.
Is it correct?
No. Because you're changing the position of the thing.
Direction.
Just now you also
you see,
you make the same thing as well.
Yeah. No, we didn't. We did something else. But you can change the position as in this is first and second. I switch. This is first and second. But can you internally switch the position?
Whoa.
Now, view.
Did you get wrong?
This is not equal. How do you make this equal? Again, if I say DC, How do I put an equal sign? And I will not still be marked wrong. You see? See, DC, I swap to CD. What must I add in front? The minus. Understand now? So, if you add a minus, he is correct. If I add a minus, he is correct. However, however, there is no way I can minus the interchange. So therefore, there is no answer. Can you follow? So I can switch the position, but internally you don't swap. If you swap the internal position, you have to add a. So far, okay?
Now, next one. So it's not equal, this is wrong. What's the answer?
Jingda.
Jingda. What's the answer?
AD.
Very good, AD. Crystal, you try.
Yeah,
a bit slow, can you all try on zero vector? Do you get this?
Yeah.
Okay, good, next. Crystal, you okay? Yeah. Okay.
Now, zero vector, this is the one I talked about just now. Yeah, I forgot this again. Is it PP or is it zero?
Zero.
PP, Okay, PP,
So just now I mentioned, if I walk from my place to cruising back again, my vector is zero, remember? So this is a zero vector. It's represented by... So this is PP. I keep forgetting this. Let me pause the video. So correction. So you write it at zero, and then this is represented by zero vector. So you change. Okay.